So today we have Dr. Saurov Mahanta from National Institute of Electronics and Information Technology, Guwahati. So today he will be speaking on protein sequence and structure databases. So I request Dr. Saurov Mahanta sir to start his lecture.
So we'll straightly go to the protein sequence databases and structure databases. Okay. So protein sequence databases, the categories of different sequence databases are again listed by different experts and nucleic acid research also. So generally the general sequence databases, that is a separate category. That there are databases like protein properties databases, protein localization targeting databases, protein sequence motifs and active site databases, protein domain databases, protein classification databases, databases of individual protein families. So there are hundreds of categories. Okay, categories. And if I'll try to go online, so if possible, I'll show you. See, this is the Nucleic Acid Research Oxford Journal Nucleic Acid Research page. So where they have classified the general sequence databases, they have made different categories. Different databases are listed in under this. So general protein sequence databases under that category. So there are databases like, say, NCBI, your famous portal nowadays for bioinformatics resources. So they have got a database. They have got a database, good database of protein, the protein sequence that is called NCBI protein. Okay.
Hi.
Slow internet. So if we go to the database category of NCBI, so you can see the NCBI protein database. Okay. So from the NCBI protein database, we can download the different sequences of protein that probably some microphone. You have to mute your.
Sorry, students, please mute your microphones.
So, here, say any protein, say human insulin or similar, any other protein which you would like to get the sequence. So, we can browse it through its keyword searching. Okay. This is the insulin sequence what we have browsed from the NCBI protein database. That is a protein sequence database. So there, similarly, there are some databases which are, say, listed by, say, one is like UniProt. So we'll see the UniProt database. Rather, it is called as UniProt knowledge base because it is a much, it provides much more information than only the sequences. So from the NCBI protein sequence database, we just download the sequences like just like any other DNA sequence or RNA sequence what we have downloaded earlier. So probably Sar and Pankaj has already discussed about this downloading of the sequence. Just we have to copy paste this sequence in a notepad file with the FASTA sign and the accessor number, and this is called the accessor number of the protein. So without the keyword, with this accessor number, we can browse the protein rightly if it is required. And any protein, if we are doing any sequencing, how the protein sequence we are getting? Protein sequences are we are getting by doing the protein sequencing. There are methods for protein sequencing. Say you probably can remember that N-terminal sequencing or Edman degradation is there. Then mass spectroscopy is hugely applied for doing the protein sequencing. So by those experimental processes, protein sequences are generated and they are deposited in the databases like NCBI Protein or say UniProt database. So in the UniProt database, the most important part is the SwissProt database of UniProt. So human insulin, this 110 amino acid long small protein, that if you browse here, okay. So here also you will get the human insulin sequence. This is the ID P01308, right? So if you go down and down, you will be getting the sequence somewhere in the file. You can download the FASTA sequence. This is the sequence. You can download it like any other sequences. So this is the SwissProt ID, right? So through the SwissProt ID also we can browse the actual protein without going for the, this is the SwissProt ID. This ID can be utilized for searching the sequences.
Excuse me, sir, could you please show once again to download the sequence from UniProt?
Right, sure, I'll show you. Now, from UniProt, like what we have done from the NCBI protein database, similarly, from the UniProt also, we can download the sequence, protein sequences. Like, one is keyword search, that is, say, human insulin. There is a keyword search method. Then you have to select out your preferences and you have to find out your most appropriate sequence, right? And then you have to click the accessor number. This is the accessor number of human insulin. So if you go down, you will get the sequence and you download it in the notepad file. This is the FASTA sequence, right?
FASTA le convert ek video.
Sorry? Hello?
FASTA le convert kori. Main FASTA le convert kori bole kuch lese koi le apni. Theek hai.
Okay. So other way is if you got the this kind of ID, UniProt ID or SwissProt ID somewhere in some paper or something, directly you can put the ID here, okay? That is called the accessor number search or searching through SwissProt ID or accessor number. Then it will be displayed directly, right?
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
So while copying, we need to copy the entire sequence, right? Starting from that greater than sign?
Yes.
And later on, you can truncate the name if required, as far as your experimental purpose is concerned. See here, if we do not need, say I'm just copying it because I'll have to share some other file. Here it will not come, I think. Notepad, I have to share you. Just a second. So I have put the sequence in notepad file, right? Can you see? So if required, I can truncate the name here, say keeping the only accessor number, insulin human, homo sapiens, or you may not like to keep other things, right? Fine. Yes, this can be saved as a FASTA file. See, in the desktop we have saved as a FASTA file. Fine.
But whatever description you want to have will be in the first line only.
Sorry, Pankaj. Hello.
Okay, here it is. Kubale question. When I read the description, that should be in the first line only, not in the second line.
Okay. Yes. The title is in the first line. Then, from the second line onwards, the sequence comes. Okay. This sequence can be analyzed. Probably you have bioedit. You are familiar with bioedit. Bora sir has extensively discussed that. Just to say, can you see the bioedit window?
Yes, sir.
This is the bioedit window that showing the insulin sequence of a human that I have taken here. So similar to any other DNA sequence analysis or other sequence analysis, so this can be bioedit can be used for say doing this kind of say analysis, like composition of the amino acid, this, that, okay. So that later on we will take it up, if time permits. Now coming back to that databases. See, there is another interesting database called Protein Information Resources, or PIR. Okay. So please try to remember, till now I have mentioned about two databases only. One is NCBI Protein and another one is SwissProt database. So why I will tell you? Because SwissProt database, the sequences are, probably you have, I have not mentioned that the sequences which are available in SwissProt database, they are reviewed sequences. Reviewed means just like peer reviewed, right? So there are other databases of UniProtKB, UniProt knowledge base. So this, you can see this P, this is reviewed. Reviewed means it is present in the SwissProt database, and reviewed sequences are those sequences which are mostly means manually annotated. Records with information extracted from literature is included there. And most importantly, they are means generated by some original protein sequencing experiments. Let me clear you one thing. Say we have two options to generate a protein sequence. How? First, if we have a gene sequence, like say gene which is encoding the human insulin, if we have the gene sequence or the cDNA sequence or the mRNA sequence, we can just convert it to a protein sequence using a software, simple software like Bioedit. Agree? That is called predicted sequence. Then another case is it is determined sequences. Determined sequences, when we talk about the determined sequence, that sequence is basically generated by a sequencing experiment. Maybe say Edman degradation, maybe a mass spectroscopy based sequencing experiment. So they are generated from an experiment, and generally the SwissProt sequences, these sequences are generally taken from the taken from the experimental information. Then another one, you can see the left hand side, there is a window is there, that is unreviewed sequence or TREMBL. TREMBL. So probably you have heard about the EMBL in these few classes. European Molecular Biology Laboratory, they have a beautiful portal called EBI, European Bioinformatics Institute, which is mostly, it is very competitive with the NCBI. Mostly they are providing very, very informative, very good databases like NCBI for tools also. So they have a database. Earlier it was known as EMBL Bank. Now it is known as ENA, European Nucleotide Archive, which is a nucleic acid sequence database. And if some software is going to is utilized for translating those EMBL database and putting it in a unreviewed manner, so they, those sequences are being accepted by the EMBL database. And SwissProt database, you can directly, you can throw the spin, tool, you can directly deposit a sequence to the SwissProt database and get an accession number after your sequence has been reviewed, right? Then your accession number can be quoted in your research paper or any other communications. Then the third database, what I'm going to discuss is the PIR, Protein Information Resources, a protein information resource. Now before that, UniProt contains, it's a consortia. So it contains UniProt, UniPreg, Proteomes, UniReference, and other some related databases. It's a UniProt is a consortium of databases, right? Out of which, sorry, in UniProt, you can see SwissProt is there, TREMBL is there, right? Both of them are present in a single platform. So they have opened a coronavirus specific database also. So we'll come to, later on we'll come to that. Now this is PIR. So similar kind of information you will get in PIR also. Resources, you can see. UniProt is also included, also can be browsed through PIR, Protein Information Resources. SARS, Text SARS, Peptide Maps, Pairwise Alignment, etc., etc. That means select a database. So iPro class, PARS, so protein name, C insulin. Okay, a lot of entries you will get. So including your that already you have browsed that particular UniProt ID, right? UniProt. So it was P1308, right? From here also you can get the same protein. So these databases are basically, they share information on a regular basis. If you deposit the information to a particular database, after 1 week or so, you will get the information available in the other databases also. Correct. Now, I'll restrict the sequence databases, general category databases into three only at this moment, because time is limited. So you can browse, if you are more interested, you can browse just the Oxford Journal's Nucleic Acid Research page. So here, general sequence databases, you can get under the protein sequence database class, you can get different databases, out of which I have discussed NCBI Protein Database, PIR, then UniProt. Okay. Now, for everything, প্ৰত্যেকটো ডেটাবেছৰ কাৰণে প্ৰত্যেকটো বস্তুৰ কাৰণে দেয়াৰ ইজ এ সুপিৰিয়ৰিটি ইনডেক্স সো ইন দেট সুপিৰিয়ৰিটি ইনডেক্স ইফ ইউ চি দ্য প্ৰটিন চিকুৱেঞ্চ ডেটাবেছেছ সো আই উইল গিভ দ্য হায়েষ্ট মাৰ্ক অৰ দ্য ৰিচাৰ্চেছ গিভ দ্য হায়েষ্ট মাৰ্ক টু সুইছপ্ৰট ডেটাবেছ বিকজ ইট কণ্টেইনছ দ্য অৰিজিনেল চিকুৱেঞ্চেছ ডিৰাইভ ফ্ৰম দ্য চৰি ডেভেলপ ফ্ৰম দ্য অৰিজিনেল প্ৰটিন চিকুৱেঞ্চিং এক্সপেৰিমেণ্টছ Then it is reviewed. Many literatures are attached to that sequence so that you get benefited or the researchers get benefited out of that particular entry. So I'll give the first preference to SwissProt. If you are looking for a protein sequence, our first and foremost database choice should be UniProt, SwissProt. Correct? So any questions so far? Because I am concluding the general sequence database part right now. Okay, let me, yes, please. Devanjan.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yes, sir. Sir, I want to ask that reviewed and unreviewed, both are there. So can the reviewed sequence can be taken for any research purpose for paper publishing and all?
Yeah, that is what I am telling. Whenever we are going for, say, searching a particular sequence, say you want to work with that NCOV or SARS coronavirus 2 main protease, right? So you want the sequence. So our first choice will be SwissProt sequence. If it is not available in SwissProt, then we will go to other databases. Are you getting the point? Because it is reviewed.
Yeah, I'm getting
original sequence. Yeah.
Okay. So if reviewed sequence is not there, then in that case we can take the unreviewed one and go for our research purpose.
Yes. You can very easily, you can very well you can use. Okay. And if the protein sequence is not there at all in the databases, you have the gene sequence and you are more very much confident that the final mRNA sequence is this one, then you can just simply translate it and you can use it in your research purpose. That will also suffice your purpose. Okay.
Thank you, sir.
Now, one question to all of you. Say I have downloaded one single sequence at a time, right? So probably you have heard about BLAST, right? So I need some homologous sequences. Homologous to what? Homologous to, say, human insulin, right? Homologous to human insulin. Then what I will do, From here, only one sequence you are getting, right? This is the sequence, right? Now I need 50 similar sequences to this. So till now, I have shown you two process of browsing the databases, sequence databases. One is through keyword. Another one is through accession number. Correct? The third one I am showing you by using a protein query. So you have a protein. You want to identify its which protein it is. That is the first thing. And you want to get some similar sequences, similar protein sequences to that sequence what you have. Then we can use the powerful tool called Protein Blast or Blast simply. Okay. So if we do the Protein Blast, selecting our database sequence, getting sequence. Sir, yes, please. Yes. Okay. So I need sequence similar to this protein. Some sequences, homologous sequences I want to get. From where? From SwissProt database. Then we will select here, UniProt, SwissProt database. BLAST-P algorithm we are using, then you do the BLAST. That means what we have done, we have taken the insulin sequence and we are putting that insulin sequence as a query to the SwissProt database. And we are trying to find out some similar sequences which is having some sort of homology, some degree of homology to our insulin sequence. Am I clear? So these are so many sequences it has generated, right? You can see the similarity percentage, identity percentage, 100%, 99, 98, 90, this, that, right? Say we want to download, say, top 10 sequences, top 10 hits. Right. So top 10 sequences we have downloaded together. I want to show you. See, all the 10 sequences are here. So we have to just. Fine. This is the first sequence. This is the second sequence, like that. Okay. So all 10 sequences can be downloaded together. Okay. Now we will go to directly go to the protein properties databases. So I'll show you the list just so you can browse later on. Protein localization and targeting database. There are so many databases are there. Then I'll go to structure database. Only one or two structure database I'll address. Protein structure databases. You can see the list. It's a huge list. Okay. There is a consortia called WWPDB, Worldwide Protein Data Bank.
Sir, what?
Worldwide Protein Data Bank.
Okay.
So there is a consortia called Worldwide Protein Data Bank where RCSB Protein Data Bank is also a member. Okay, a member is RCSB Protein Data Bank. So it is basically not only a protein structure database, but also a macromolecular structure database. Means apart from the protein, there are other structures also, which are biologically called macromolecules. Then there is a database called PDB Europe. This is Protein Data Bank Europe. So mainly we will see the first, the Research Collaborative for Structural Bioinformatics, RCSB. There is a consortia of different institutes, three different institutes. Now here and there, you can see today's date, you can see you have 1,62,269 biological macromolecular structures. Okay. Say the most talked about structure nowadays. The main protease structure of SARS coronavirus 2, which is almost 95% similar sequentially and structurally to the SARS coronavirus 1 main protease. Okay, so this structure. How to download this structure? This is the structure. Lot of information you will get. And this is the worldwide PDB link, what I was talking about, WWPDB link. And this is the symbol. So this is lot of things will be there. Secondary structure information, this, that, okay. Now, just first we'll see how to download the PDB format file. Okay. So you can also download it. You can also download the same.
Excuse me, sir.
Yes.
Please. Can we download the file in PDB format?
Hmm. Yes, we have downloaded the file in PDF format, right? Yes. Yes, please continue.
That's what I was asking, like there are so many options.
Yeah, PDB format you have to download. Then you can download a simple software that is called Resmol. Okay. It is Resmol. First you can download this Resmol and you can see the structure. There, I'm showing you the structure in a different file, different software. Can you see the protein? Yes.
Yes, sir.
Okay. It's a beautiful structure of alpha beta structure. Means alpha beta means both alpha helices and beta strands are available. So if you see more minutely, you can see the hydrogen bonds. Okay. So these are some solvents. This plus signs remain during the crystallization process. So that is how the file is downloaded and what it contains. That you see by clicking the So Resmol you can download it, PDB file you can download it separately. So you can see this is the PDB file. You can see it's a huge file containing all the atomic information, right? So these are required for displaying the structure in a three-dimensional environment. So this is the WWPDB resource. This is again, I'm telling, this is RCSB protein database. Then I'll show you another interesting structure database that is called PDB sum. It's a secondary database. Secondary database means from the PDB they have taken the information and they have done some analysis. You cannot deposit directly to a PDB sum database. If you develop a X-ray crystallography structure, you won't be able to deposit it into PDB sum, but you can deposit it to protein data bank. Say 6LU7. So you'll be appreciating how they are doing the analysis. So it will, all analysis will be kept here, including the Ramachandran plot. See the Ramachandran plot. More than 90% amino acids are there in the red region or the allowed regions. That means the structure is very good because it is an X-ray crystallographic structure. So it has to have this kind of good Ramachandran plot. Then you can see some of the more features, like this is the secondary structural information of the protein structure. This is the topological diagram of the protein. Fine. It has a ligand binded to it. There's a small ligand. Alanine, valine, leucine. It's a tripeptide. Okay.
Dr. Mahanta, excuse me.
So this is the structural database part. Just I wanted to show you many other databases, but time, because of that technical problem, we started very late. So anyway, we'll meet again. So now, if you have any specific query, question to Sar or me or Pankaj, you can just throw the questions. We'll try to address.
Sir,